Hello students, welcome to RR session. Today we are going to learn lesson number 6, Tolerance, the Transformation. Before moving on to the explanation of the lesson, let us first learn what is tolerance and what is transformation. Now, tolerance means accepting and respecting the differences in others. Tolerance shows the respect and concern for the people in our society. Now, students, we all know that no two individuals in this world look the same, think the same, feel the same, or believe in the same values. Hence, if we realize that such differences are not only inevitable but exciting and motivating, then it means we show the way for true tolerance. Now, what is transformation? Transformation means the task of changing who you are and becoming the person you want to be. It means if you have anger attitude towards everyone, but slowly and gradually, if you try to change your anger, and your nature is changing, then it means you are in the process of transformation. Once there was a guru who had many followers because he never discriminated among the people who came to visit him from different parts of the country and belonged to all walks of life. But one thing always upset the guru. The people who lived in the ashram were very quarrelsome. They always used to fight among themselves on small things. The rude words which they exchanged pained the guru. The guru always asked himself the reason, why do these people get so angry? One day, watching unobserved, he saw two persons fighting over food. One was serving the other, and the person receiving the meal was arguing that he was not being given enough. An argument increased, and the guru was shocked at the angry glares and raised voices. He returned to his hut, feeling sad. The guru wondered how to improve the situation. He increased the number of religious lectures and gave each person special attention and advice. The disciples' respect for their guru increased, but this did not result in their treating each other with tolerance and respect. The guru then resolved or determined to seek divine help. He hid himself from people, maintained silence and meditated. At the end of a week, he was rewarded with a vision of celestial light. The guru sat astonished or motionless as the Lord spoke to him. The guru could not believe his ears. "Is it really you, Lord?" he asked, his voice filled with delight and disbelief. "Tell me, what can I do for you?" said the Lord. Now, students, here the Lord in the form of a light appeared in front of Guru, and Guru told his problem to light, that is Lord. "You know all things, Lord," said the Guru humbly. "The members of my ashram are filled with dislike of one another. Lord, if you could just stay with us for a week, they will definitely become better human beings." The Lord replied, "I will surely come and stay forever. I shall not be seen in my usual form, but in the appearance of any one of your disciples." It means Lord said that I will come in the form of any student in your ashram. After this, the guru opened the door of his hut and called all his followers to a meeting and told them that the Lord has spoken to him, and the disciples listened to him in a wonder. When the Guru went on to inform them of the Lord's wish to live among them as one of them, they rejoiced. They became happy that now Lord will come in our ashram. Days went by, and there was a gradual change in the atmosphere of the ashram. As each disciple went about his daily work, he thought, "Is this one sitting near me, the Lord in disguise? Who could be the person?" Nobody knew, and as a result, everyone was careful. Each thought, "How can I fight with anyone here? What if he is the one in whom the Lord resides?" Now the ashram dwellers began to see holiness in everyone and took every opportunity to be kind, helpful, and cautious. Love and harmony prevailed, and the ashram was transformed into the place where people lived happily, accepting and respecting the differences and feelings of others. Value gems which we have learned from this lesson are: number one, tolerance means accepting and respecting the differences in others. Number two, appreciating what is good and unique in others helps us to be more tolerant towards others. Number three, tolerance leads to peace and harmony. So students, we should always accept and respect the feelings of others and appreciate the good qualities of others so that peace and harmony spreads everywhere. Auto-suggestions of this lesson are: number one, I interact with people of different backgrounds. Number two, I respect differences of opinion. Number three, I consider everyone worthy of respect. So now onwards, students, you should always try to mix with people of different nature, backgrounds, and opinions, and always respect their emotions and feelings. Students, hope you have understood this lesson. Thank you.